That traditional work model has changed, or I guess I should probably say that model to work has changed, and it seems like it's morphed into something called the gig economy. What is the gig economy?
The gig economy is when you're actually not an employee. You're an independent contractor. If you want to work for somebody for a particular period of time, you say yes. If you don't want to work for them, you say no. If they want to use you, they say they let you get work, and if they don't want to use you, they have no obligation to call you in the next day. Uber drivers, delivery people, people like that, and usually done through apps, which is where the name gig comes from. It's apps, your phone, your digital device.
Sorry, you mentioned someone like Uber or Foodera. Is it specific to certain occupations or generations, would you say?
Well, I have a relative who's working as an Uber driver who couldn't get a job otherwise. So it's not necessarily, although a lot of younger people tend to, well, I won't say that because that wouldn't really be fair, but disproportionately compared to, say, our generation or my generation, in any event, they who want steady jobs, they care more about work-life balance in my experience, and they're happy to work when they want to and take time off when they don't want to and have longer vacations or longer weekends.
In terms of having the support and I guess those traditional benefits, when you do belong to a company or to an employer, you no longer have that cover.
That's true. And a lot of employers in the gig economy may say, gee, we want to extend those benefits because we're to attract people to us. But the problem they have is if they extend those benefits, they're more likely to be deemed to be an employer. And the whole reason they do it this way as an employer is to not be employer, to not have employment obligations, not have to pay damages for wrongful dismissal, not have to pay overtime, which is really hard to track in a gig economy, in a non-traditional workforce where people are working here and there and everywhere. It's hard to track exactly when they're working, at least in some cases. So they don't want to worry about that, and that's why they opt for that model. It's much less onerous on an employer.
I'm wondering whether or not this leaves you out of business.
It does. Actually, it is a real impact in the future in employment law, because as long as the law is as it is now, these people are not employees who can sue for wrongful dismissal. These are not employees who can sue in various ways for aspects of their employment, for constructive dismissal, for example, for overtime, for occupational health and safety violations. They're not employees, they're independent contractors. The more people work that way, the less work there is for employment lawyers. Right. Happily, I'm old enough, I'm not going to have to worry about that for too many more years.
Are you seeing other models usurp the traditional working model?
Well, yes. You used to think, well, Japan, people work for life. Well, in Canada, people didn't work for life, but they worked for a long time. The average employee would work for 10 or 20 years at the same employer before considering going somewhere else. And in fact, if you only worked for 2 or 3 years, it was almost a bad mark on your record. Now people are moving jobs, well, they're like toilet paper, just taking out and discarding it and moving on to the next employer if they get a better job somewhere else. And that's affecting employment lawyers too, because you can sue a lot for a lot more if somebody's been there 20 years, they've been there 1 year. But yes, even beyond the gig economy, there's less loyalty to your employer.
Are you seeing jobs, I guess, moving away here, or employment moving away from Canada? Are you seeing anything like that in your experience?
To some extent, because people will move where the jobs is, and right now the States is a real generator of jobs. And in fact, they're the generator of jobs for us too, because they're doing so well, and there's so much full capacity in the U.S., there's more likely to get orders from Canadian companies. But to the extent that there's so much work in the U.S., they can't find employees, they become an engine that suck employees from all around the world, including from Canada, to those better paying, busier, more lucrative jobs in the U.S.